Hello, everybody. 我是木木，欢迎收听这一期的早安英文。
我是你们的美国朋友 TJ。
欢迎我们的美国朋友 TJ。今天呢，我们要说一说美国的酒吧。说到美国的酒吧呢，我们就会想到一个胡子拉碴的大叔举着一杯啤酒，嘴里嘟嚷个不停。可是拜托，这些都是几个世纪前的老套情节了，好吗？如今我们的酒吧是怎样的呢？在美国，酒吧和夜店又有什么样的区别呢？今天我们就一起来聊一聊这个话题。TJ, what's the biggest differences between bars and clubs?
Bar is gonna be the place where you can get with friends and kind of get together and tell stories and jokes while having a few drinks.
Yes.
Maybe watch a game or talk to the bartender about your problems.
Well, 在 TJ 的眼中呢，酒吧呢就是三五好友可以小聚一下，可以喝一点小酒，放松放松，聊聊天，吐吐槽什么的。比如说呢，你还可以看一看球赛，或者是和帅酒保谈谈心。那么 TJ, 你知道 Do you know what's mean 吐槽？
What is 吐槽？
It means complain, always complaining about something.
I see, so my girlfriend 吐槽。
Yes, maybe. Okay, now.
Now, a club, however, is a place where a bunch of douchey dudes try to get laid and, you know, with annoyingly loud music. I can't stand it.
Well, this. 那么夜店呢，其实直白一点来说呢，就是花天酒地的一个地儿，有着比较骚动的音乐和不纯洁的动机。但是我觉得呢，可能也不全是这样的。在这里出现了一个非常隐晦的单词，叫做 laid。那么它的意思呢，就是 have sex。好，我们继续。酒驾这个事儿，我们都知道在中国是万万使不得的，不知道在美国这边自称自由的土地会不会是被允许的呢？ So TJ, I have a question for you. Drive after drinking is illegal in China, you know that?
Oh yeah.
Even you're not drunk, then is it okay for American to drive after drinking?
No, hell no, hell no, it's not okay. I meanIf you're drinking and you're driving, you really are a moron. Especially in such a big city where there's so many taxis.
当然啦，在自称自由的国度，醉酒驾驶也是万万不可以的。尤其是在有很多计程车的这样一个大城市，更是不被允许的。
Now, that being said, there is a limit to how drunk it can be. If you have, say, a beer and drive and get pulled over by a police officer, what they'll do is they'll check your alcohol level with what's called a breathalyzer. If you're under the limit for that state, you won't get a ticket.
TJ 告诉我们呢，大家也别紧张了，其实喝一瓶啤酒是没有关系的。要是万一被警察召唤了，测一下你的酒精含量，放心，如果你只喝了一瓶啤酒，是不会被开罚单的。这里出现了一个非常好的单词，叫做 breathalyzer， 它的意思呢，就是体内酒量测定器，也就是测你有没有醉酒驾驶的那个机器。那我们一起来读一遍吧。Breathalyzer. 今天呢，我和我们的美国朋友 TJ 聊了聊在美国酒吧和夜店的区别。好啦，虽然木木老师呢是很少去夜店的，但是还是会发现夜店的保安呢是特别多的，通常还是那种肌肉非常健硕的 man。但为什么在酒吧我们却很少看见保安呢？啊，其实我特别想知道保安在英文里面应该怎么来说呢 ？So TJ,、how to say?保安 in English.
保安是 bouncers.
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 那你知道 bouncers 在中文里面 how to say it in Chinese?
保安
Yes, that's great. Okay, now why do clubs have bouncers but bars don't?
Well, because a bar is a place where people go to hang out.
Yeah.
You know? Now a club is a place where people go to get shit-faced.
Well, shit-faced. Why do they want to get drunk? It sounds dangerous for young ladies.
Maybe a little. Have you ever had to deal with a drunk 22-year-old who thinks he's being disrespectful? It's awful. That's why we pay people to deal with it for us. Those people are called bouncers.
Well, it makes sense. Now I can understand. 那 TJ 告诉我们呢，在夜店呢，其实就是去买醉的地方了。喝酒喝醉了就容易闹事，闹事的时候呢，肯定就需要一个保安做一个解决的人，对吧？在这里呢，这个 shit-faced 它指的就是你非常非常非常的醉， really 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 drunk。我有一个美国朋友告诉我，他21岁，那天非常的开心，自己终于可以光明正大的喝酒了。我就很吃惊啊，为什么美国这么自称自由的国度，21岁才能够喝酒呢？我记得我初3毕业的时候就开始喝了人生的第一杯啤酒。 So I have a question, TJ. The national minimum drinking age is 21 in USA. Why 21 rather than 18? Since 18 is usually the age of adulthood.
Yeah, it's a stupid law. 18-year-olds can smoke and get cancer, take out loans and drown themselves in debt, or join the military and die for their country, but they can't buy a beer. It's ridiculous.
Wow, yes, it's ridiculous. TJ 觉得呢，这个规定特别的傻。这个地方自动消音。18岁可以抽烟，甚至可以自己贷款，并且还可以参军，就是不可以喝酒。那 TJ 觉得是特别的荒唐，觉得天理何在呀
？I think it's because the government thinks that kids are 18 and they're not responsible enough to buy alcohol. But it still doesn't make sense when you think about the points that I just covered.
Yes， 好了 ，TJ 告诉我们，其实就是政府觉得可能18岁还没有足够的责任来买醉吧。其实呢，我特别的好奇这个法律到底是怎么执行下去的？难道这些酒吧和夜店就靠卖一些软饮来维持生计，卖橙汁儿、卖可乐吗？在这里呢，我有一个单词想要问一下我们的 TJ。So TJ, how to say 禁止 in English？
禁止是 prohibition。
Prohibition。
That's it.
Yeah, so I have a question.
Okay.
Could you tell me some story about Prohibition era? Why the government need that law and how the bars and clubs operated in that time? Only sought soft drink.
No. Okay, I could go into this a lot. So I'll save the juicy details for another podcast. But the bars during this time were called speakeasies.And they were controlled by criminals, and one way or another, it was a crazy time.
那么在那段时期呢，很多酒吧都被一些犯罪大头所控制着。总之呢，是一个非常恐怖的、非常紧张的、非常怎么说，让人很恐慌的一个年代吧。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频了。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
我是木木，我们下期见。
And this has been TJ， 下期见。
拜拜。
Okay, 木木 ，So did you get enough information?
Yes, I get enough information today.
All right, great. So how about a pretty girl like you go out with a handsome guy like me and get some beers?
Well, I don't like clubs, but I like beers.
Well, let's go get some beers.
Cool.